Hey everyone, it's me, the Afro Hamurai. Hey, Unison Audio. You guys, yeah, leave this video alone. If you try and copyright take down it or anything like that, it's not going to end well for you. I'm making that very clear now. The Unison MIDI Chord Pack. I've been advertised it and I didn't really care too much about it, so I didn't really bother going ahead and getting it. But then I got advertised it again recently on my Facebook, and they were like giving away a free version of it that had like a few of their bits and pieces. This was originally going to be a review of that free chord pack, but taking into account what my experience was trying to download it, I kind of feel like I need to give you some more information. Also, in advance, I'm a bit ill, which is why I don't sound as good as I can do. I'm going to fix it later in EQ and so on, but I'm still going to sound a little bit, you know, sniffly or nasally, so sorry. Yeah, let's do it. Let's go. Well, you know, as I said, a lot of people get advertised this. I'm sure that you guys might already know what it is, but if you don't, the Unison MIDI Chord Pack is meant to be a game changer, something groundbreaking that's going to help you make music so much better than what you've been making music before. And it's going to make you a better producer. You're going to be making hit tracks. It's definitely not just a collection of MIDI chords that you could drag into your arrangement and then they do like their chord thing and like just some chord progressions that you smack onto a track and then you start building on top of that. It's not absolutely 100% terrible, but it's just MIDI chords. Genuinely, most of your DAWs have stuff built in that will let you use chords. In fact, even on their own website, they show you Ableton working with it, and Ableton has a chord function in it for MIDI. You press a note, it puts other notes into your MIDI, the end, that's how it works. You get it in Ableton Live Intro, which is an extra $30 compared to the Unison MIDI Chord Pack. The difference is that for that extra $30, you're also getting an entire DAW. What's even weirder about it, not only the fact that they're showing it in a DAW that has a built-in chord option, is that with a lot of the YouTubers that are doing the adverts for this, and this isn't shade towards the YouTubers, this is just me saying exactly what I saw. Like, one of them had an Ableton Push, which, hold on a minute, I'm actually going to go and get, wait right here. They had a Push. The Push is brilliant because it's about £500 worth of equipment. I got this used from my friend, but it's about £500, and built into it, it has the ability for you to make chords, and you use it with the pads. So you don't need it. I don't see why he's advertising the MIDI chord pack when this does it, like, for real. This is where we get into what I didn't like about downloading my demo. So to download the free pack, you needed to give them your email address and name. Seems pretty fair, right? Yeah, except that I got two emails. One of them was the download link. The other one, I'm not even joking, was setting up an account on their website. I didn't want that. Why would I want to make an account on your website? I haven't even decided if I like your thing yet. What's better though is that before I got the emails about the free thing that I wanted to download to try out their product, I was given a web page with a video and a timer. Now, I didn't click the video because I didn't want to play it, but I waited to see what would happen at the end of the timer, and what did I get? Boom! Discount. Now, I blurred out the discounted price just because I'm not sure if they're going to try and come at me for it, but genuinely, you're giving me a discount on a product I haven't even decided I like yet based off of a download I haven't even been able to do. Dudes, what's wrong with you? Like, for real, if you want me to buy it, I'm fine. Like, look, just let me make the decision first. Let me just try it and see what's going on in it. So I get the email after already being offered a discount on their price for something that I'm not even sure if I wanted yet. In the email that I got, they already then put a link saying, again, hey, we're going to give you a discount so that you can buy the MIDI pack if you want to. And then the day after, I got exactly the same email as a just in case you didn't see it. Homie, for real, you made an account for me and you sent me an email with the link, like literally after you already showed me that you were willing to give me a discount on a product I didn't want. You'll need to chill, okay? For real, I'm not even joking. I'm laughing. There's a lot of laughing in this video, but it's just because it's actually hilarious. Also, they reminded me that that link with the discounted price is only valid for 2 days, so if I don't pick it up in those 2 days, I have to pay the full price. To try and give them the benefit of the doubt, I was like, you know what? Let me actually be a bit fair. Let me go as if I'm going to use it, because maybe it's just that they want to make sure that I'm getting the best deal, because that's actually pretty fair, and I would be very happy to know that I'm getting a really good deal. Nope. When I went to purchase it, as if I was going to buy it, before putting my card details in, absolutely it was just like a little checkbox that was like, hey, do you want to have this thing that you need to get the most out of your other thing? And it's like, dude, I haven't even bought the product that you're trying to get me to buy and that you're advertising to me, and you're telling me that to get the most out of it, I need this other thing that has MIDI melodies on it. Are you for real? Like, genuinely? Look, Unison Audio, if you're watching this, like, for real, you'll just need to stop with this, okay? Like, you need to just let me try your thing out and actually, for real, like, see whether I have the value in it or not, right? I don't need to be emailed constantly after just trying to get a demo just to be able to figure out whether or not I want to buy it or not. Like, I can make that decision myself. I'm a grown adult. Treat me like one and actually at least have enough respect for yourselves that you stand by your product. Like, it should be able to stand on its own without you constantly telling me that I need to buy it. If you're in a position where you know information and you're coming with, like, more knowledge than the person who you're talking to, it's kind of fair for you to tell that person all the information, especially if you're selling them something. That seems pretty fair. Baby Audio, with their new plugin, Smooth Operator, on their website, they tell you factually just exactly what their product does. They're just like, this is what it does. It's meant to be an alternative to compression and EQ and like tonal shaping, but something that does it all in one. And then nearer the bottom, they tell you exactly what spectral shaping is and they explain how it works just really factually. And they compare it to other technologies. Also, they let you download the trial just from there. You just click it and you download it and you can try it and that's it. Let's see how Unison Audio do. I'm already laughing because I know it's funny. On their site, they say that the secret to making a hit song isn't spending lots on studio gear or special mixing techniques, which, I gotta be real, that's true. That's exactly right. Like, you can spend a huge amount on studio gear and you can learn some really cool, tricky mixing techniques, but if you don't actually know what you're doing, then you're not going to get good results out of it. And if you don't know how you're using your gear, it's not going to sound good. That's very fair. But then they go on to say that it's not about spending lots of time producing, which is... what? Do you think any well-known producers just woke up one day and then made their hit song and went, oh, well, you know, that must have been because I had that one specific thing in my back pocket? No. They practiced. Don't be silly. They even do it in the next bit. When they talk about chord progressions being the best bit of like a song, they say that the only way to learn about chord progressions is either by going to music school and like spending thousands of dollars or by going onto YouTube and watching YouTube tutorials and getting like drip feeds of information here and there. As if books don't exist. Dude, on your own thing, you make an ebook about melody. Books exist, guys. Books exist. And as before, they shouldn't need to like pretend like things don't exist and omit them to make their product look better. Baby Audio doesn't run away from the fact that like EQs and compressors exist and that you can try and get their results with EQs and compressors. They just say that theirs does it easier, which it does. I've used it, I've reviewed it, it just does. That's just a fact. And you can try it for yourself to see if that's the case. Soundtoys, another really brilliant manufacturer of plugins, with Little Walter Boy, they don't go and go, oh, well, this is the secret weapon of hip-hop. This is how everyone makes their hip-hop. If you don't have this, you're not making hip-hop. No. They just say, hey, this is how you get them hip-hop style, like, you know, vocals. This is how you get that rap style vocal going on. You know, this is something really cool for it. At most, when they kind of hype up their own thing, they're not trying to make it seem better than it is. They just show genuine pride. They talk about their team that helped to make this. They talk about how it is that they got to where they are. They just want you to be as excited and as proud about their plugin as they are. How are these guys trying to push a folder of MIDI files that have chords in them as if they're groundbreaking and they're going to shake up the music industry? Come on now. Be real. You know what? Just get some books. Genuinely, that's the best way to do it. Like, the MIDI chord pack might be saying that it's best for people who have really limited knowledge of music theory. But if you know you have limited knowledge of music theory, it's better for you to try and improve your knowledge of music theory rather than just try and find a shortcut that means that you don't learn anything. Yeah, music theory's hard. I know. I'm still trying to learn a bit more about it myself to be a better producer. But when you learn it, you end up actually having that knowledge to hand. You don't need to use files that you drag and drop to make your tracks. You just make your tracks better because you know what you're doing a bit more. And yeah, you can get books for like less than £10 here in the UK or less than $15 likely in the US that will teach you music theory to at least a very good basic level, and you'll be able to do most of what you would use the Unison MIDI chord pack to do anyway. In fact, I went onto Reddit and I looked up some books for music theory that should be pretty good. And you know what? One of the books that they suggested comes at about the same cost. Looks like something that I would actually expect to see in music schools if you wanted to learn music theory. So you can teach yourself music theory at the same cost as the Unison MIDI chord pack. Genuinely, I don't think this is something that like existing music producers need to worry about, because existing music producers likely wouldn't get something like this. But if you're a new music producer, don't fall for these sorts of things. There isn't any sort of like magic program or magic MIDI pack or magic sample pack that's all of a sudden going to make all of your music the best music in the world. All of the plugins, all of the samples, all of the doors, all of the like synthesizers, they're all just tools. They're all just tools for you to use as the producer to make that music. So if you don't have that knowledge, you're not going to make good music. That's not me trying to be mean. That's just me saying, like, if you're finding that you're not getting good music out, maybe it's either a little bit of practice that you need, or it's just like using some books or someone to try and understand a bit more what it is that you need to do. Or just going onto places like Reddit, or even like here in my comment section, just asking for help and like waiting for someone to respond to you. Like, just do that sort of stuff. Try and learn more. But things like this, they ain't gonna help you out. And I gotta be real, from how Unison are like as a company, at least from my experience and from the experience of lots of people on Trustpilot who have left negative reviews, I wouldn't suggest it. You know, yeah, cool.